Welcome to Bologna, everyone. Great to connect with you. Great to see you back. We're going to talk today about the subject of substance. What is substance? Why is substance so important? It's something that you're going to hear more and more about. There's a recent EU directive, the EU Substance Directive, around it. And this is really striking at the heart of what people have been doing for quite a few years in order to basically break the law, do tax evasion instead of tax avoidance. But it was hard to get away with, right? And they're tightening up the rules. So what does this mean? Substance is actually having something behind your structure, okay? So let me give you an example. Let's say that traditionally, the most popular place to form a company internationally for offshore purposes was British Virgin Islands, BVI. What would happen though? Was there any business there? No, there was just a mailbox at best in most cases. And you can tell this, there were like a few hundred thousand businesses registered there, but that's probably more than the population of BVI. So as a result, can you really say that your company is there if you don't have any substance there? If you understand that term substance, right? There's a form. The form is, hey, I have a piece of paper registered which says I have a company, but there's nothing happening there. And so more and more, if you want to legally plan your international taxes, you need to have substance. And this is what we're talking about to an increasing degree, and what's really the issue. If you come and talk to us, I'm going to hammer with you, and a bunch of people are going to hammer with you, hopefully. What's the substance behind what you have going on? So let's talk about it in two different ways. One is substance that works against you, and one is substance that works for you, okay? So the substance that works against you is quite simply this. If you're like, hey, I'm in Australia, and I have a company in Seychelles. Well, you're in Australia. You have employees in Australia. Your substance is in Australia. What does that mean? That means the court is typically going to rule and go towards where the substance is. It doesn't matter where the company is, okay? Now, we get into the technicalities of the rules, and that's why, you know, people call us and we help them out, etc. But you want to make sure you understand those rules and want to make sure that when you're thinking, how do I build substance? And this is going to dramatically change your decisions. I'm going to talk about that in just a second. So that would be substance that works against you. That's where the substance is in a place that is harmful to you rather than helpful to you, okay? The next side is substance that works for you. So this is where, for example, again, let's say that I'm in Australia, but I co-own a company with some people and none of our employees are in Australia. Our employees are abroad. Let's just say for a minute that it doesn't really matter where they are, but the point is they're not in Australia and they are somewhere else. Okay, so I can genuinely say to Australia, I can say, hey look, our company's abroad. Our company's not in Australia. Now, if you're doing work, then that's a little bit, you know, it gets trickier, etc. If you're managing the company, that gets trickier and so on. But at least you can say, hey, there's substance abroad. Now, if you really want to go the step further, and this is what we're increasingly aiming to do, and we're thinking a lot about in terms of structures because it matters for banking and it matters for tax, we're going to say, hey, I want substance where the company is, okay? So why is this important? If you're at all connected with this, you're going to find that more and more banks are getting tougher. They're shutting bank accounts down. They're making it very, very difficult. Oh, sorry. And we don't want that to be, we want the business to be stable, right? We don't want to be running around having to chase the next bank account and going from one bank to the next and trying to find whatever, you know, that's not a good situation to be in. So how do we avoid that? Well, usually, if you have a genuine business, meaning you have employees, you have, say, office space, you have financial activity in a country, usually you won't have problems banking there. So people will say, oh, you know, it's hard to bank in Hong Kong. It's like, well, yeah, when you have nothing in Hong Kong, it's tough to bank in Hong Kong, right? Georgia's getting harder. A bunch of TBC now, last I checked, was saying, hey, look, if you don't have substance in Georgia, we don't really want you banking at TBC, okay? So, but on the other hand, is it getting hard for local businesses? No, it's not hard at all because they have real stuff. The same is true in Andorra. Andorra is really hard to bank in right now. But if you're a local Andorran business where you've got employees, you've got a storefront, you've got whatever, you have no problems. You know, they're going to compete for your business at that stage. So the question is, when you're thinking about where to build, you're not just thinking anymore about, hey, where do I pay less tax? Where is it easy to incorporate? Where is it cheap? Where do I have less requirements? Where do I have more privacy? You're not just thinking about those things. You're also now thinking about, hey, where do I bank? And in order to bank there, what's going to be make create stability? What's going to help me on the tax side long term with the tax authorities? How am I going to be able to get a tax residency certificate there, etc.? And this is all coming from substance. This is all coming from where you have people. And what does that mean? Well, let's look at the traditional places. Would I ever in a million years want to do business in Vanuatu? No, it's garbage. I wouldn't want to do business there because the internet sucks. I'm not going to have good access to talent. I'm not going to have good infrastructure in general. Maybe the time zones are no good, etc., right? So this rules out a lot of the island nations. You start going through the Caribbean. Do I want to hire people in Anguilla? No. In Antigua? No. In Nevis? No. On and on and on. Lots of examples of where I don't want to be because the talent pool isn't deep enough, the wages are too high, the infrastructure's not good, the work ethic isn't good, etc. So what we're looking for now is we're looking for where can I go that I can get low wages, that I can get a deep talent pool, that I can get people who speak the language, who are on the right time zone, have good infrastructure, have a good work ethic, etc. So I actually have a business purpose that's going to advance me and give me a more competitive advantage, and I layer that with tax and asset protection and these other things. So that's the way that we're headed today, and if you want to help with that, reach out to us. We'll help you out. Hope that's helpful, and we'll talk to you soon.